Hello all, this is Ben Falk for KillerSites.com. Welcome to a couple part series on building a simple PHP based login system. We'll be using PHP, connecting to our database using MySQLi, and I'll also be discussing the MVC or Model View Controller pattern and PHP sessions. Although this tutorial is aimed at beginners, I do expect that you have at least a basic understanding of PHP and MySQL. I'll do my best to explain things as clearly as I can. First off, let me show you what we'll be building today. It's pretty simple. It consists of a login page, which allows users to log in, and then a members page. This page isn't accessible to normal users. A register members page, where the member could go ahead and add in additional users, or finally a logout page where they log out and then be redirected back to the login page. So what do you need to follow along with me? Well, obviously you're going to need a computer that has either WAMP or MAMP installed. In my case, I'm using MAMP, and that allows you to use PHP and MySQL on your computer. So it's basically a web server on your own computer. And you need some sort of text editor. In my case, I use Coda, but you're welcome to use whatever you're comfortable with. As we get started here, let me briefly discuss the different files in our application and how I've structured them. So we have two folders. We have an includes folder and a views folder. And includes includes a config file and a database file. And the views controls the CSS and HTML that we're going to be presenting to the user. And then finally, we have a couple other files. We have login, logout, members, register, and temp.php. And in every case, for example, login, we have an opening and closing PHP tag and a brief description, including the file name and what this file does. So let me talk about how I've structured this application. I'm using a modified version of MVC, which stands for Model View Controller. And that's a pretty popular pattern because it allows for clear separation between the business logic, in our case the PHP, and what's presented to the user, HTML and CSS. So the M in MVC stands for the model. That basically processes input and handles any business logic. So that's going to include most of our PHP code. We have the view, which is the V. And that's usually HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and that's what's presented to the user. And then finally, we have the controller, C, which handles user requests and knows how to process them and pass them on to whatever resources are necessary to carry them out. So the big advantage of using MVC is obviously the clear separation between business logic and presentational HTML, and that means code is a lot more structured, and thus easier to test, maintain, and reuse. In this application, I'm using a modified version of MVC. Basically, our model and our controller are combined. So we're going to have one main file, for example, login.php, and this will include all the PHP logic. And then once this code completes, it's going to be passed on to the view, in this case, vlogin.php. So I didn't want to make an incredibly complicated system. A lot of systems, CodeIgniter for example, Cake PHP, etc., a lot of those use a central index.php file. And based on the URL, that index.php file then passes it on to the necessary model or view. I didn't want to get too complicated, but this does definitely help give us a clear separation between PHP and HTML. Let's get started building this application. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to PHP MyAdmin, and I've set up a database here that I've called Login, and I'm going to create a new table in that database called Members, and it's going to have three fields. The first field is going to be ID, it's going to be an int, and if you scroll to the right here, it's going to be the primary key and auto increment. So that means it's going to be unique to this table. We're going to have a username, which is going to be a varchar with 32 characters, And we're also going to have a password with 32. Let's go ahead, hit save. Okay, so we got this table set up. Now, let's go back to your text editor for a minute, and I'm going to open up temp.php. And the next step is going to be to add a user to PHP MyAdmin, so to populate that table we just created with a little bit of data. What we do need to do first, though, is I want to use a PHP function called md5, which is a way to encrypt strings. So I want to use that to encrypt our password string in our database. So let's start off by doing this. We're going to do echo md5. And the first string we're going to put in will be the password that we want to use. So admin is what I'm going to use. And then I'm going to also add at the end here, I'm going to add an additional string. And this is going to be made up of random letters, numbers, and symbols intended to be secure. So I'm just going to type a couple characters. Okay, so that should be good. 5 or 6, perfectly fine. So I'm going to finish off this line. And what this is it's often called a salt. It makes our passwords more secure. So let's go ahead and preview this. And we get this string of 32 characters. So I'm going to copy it, go back to PHP MyAdmin, and let's insert some data. We're going to insert an admin user, and we'll paste in that value that we just got. Okay, so if we go to browse, we have one user set up with this password. Let's close out part one by editing two files. So I'm going to go back to Coda, and let's go back to edit view. First of all, I'm going to copy this random value that we created, and I'm going to go to our includes folder and open up config.php. And we're going to add a quick user authentication comment. So user authentication, and underneath it I'm going to add a config variable, and I'm going to call this salt, and I'm going to paste in the value that we just used. So again, the idea behind this is that adding a salt to our passwords makes them significantly more secure, because for example, let's go back to our temp.php. The way MD5 works is it translates a string into a string of 32 characters, and every time you translate admin, it's going to result in the same resulting 32 character string. So there are things out there called rainbow tables, which basically it's a long list of regular words and their equivalent, their MD5 equivalent. So it's important that you add some sort of additional protection. In our case, we're appending a more secure string on the end to make it harder for people to guess the password. So I'm going to go back to config. So we have set up this salt. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set up error reporting. And I'm going to set up MySQLi error reporting. Like so. So this line you'd probably want to remove once the site was to go live, but it helps for testing purposes in case you have errors in your MySQLi code. So that's the end of our config file, and the last thing for this part of the tutorial is to go to the database.php file, and I'm going to just add some database settings. So we're going to include server, user, pass, and finally DB for database. So keep in mind that your exact settings may be different from mine. Localhost probably will stay the same. If you're on a Windows machine, I believe the username is root and the password is blank, like so. But if I'm on a Mac, I use both root root. And if you've named your database login, that's what you use. Otherwise, replace this value with the name of your database. Okay, so with these in place, let's go ahead and connect to the database. So I'm going to do that with MySQLi equals new MySQLi, and we're going to pass in the server, user, pass, and database, like so. Okay, so in this part one, we've gone over the basic structure of our files, we've talked a little bit about MVC, and we've set up our database, config, and db.php files.